it looks like I haven't slept in 2 days, it's because I haven't, so. Hello there, my name is Alexis, and in today's video, I'm going to be doing a recap of episode 5 of season 4 of Escape the Night. A lot of stuff happened in this episode. We have new conspiracies to cover. I am so excited. But before we get started, if you guys would like to see more recap episodes, because I know you guys have been loving them, and I cannot ever thank you guys enough for just the support that you give me for these videos, because I am doing a recap episode for each and every episode of Escape the Night that comes out, along with just regular content, please hit that subscribe button. It really, really helps me out, and we are on the road to 2.1k. And yeah, without further ado, let's get started. So the sorceress talking to Mortimer while they were trying to solve the clues in their challenge, I just find that really sketchy. I don't know, because she's been talking to everybody on the side, and like, I really want to trust her because of the character development she has and how much she's actually been helping the group try to get out. But I don't know, just every time she pulls somebody aside and talks to them, I'm hoping I'm just overreacting and she's actually trying to help, and maybe just that's her strategy, is to talk to other people and try to lure them into her side, because especially Mortimer over here, that boy needs that, because he's a little sketch. Colleen taking charge and giving orders and trying to really, really just get everybody together, I love that for her. It's going to be so good for her game. It's going to show her leadership skills, her game skills. She's going to help them get really far, and now that her and Joey's relationship is being mended, I know that's definitely gonna get her far with this. I keep up and I might jump out the window. From a personal standpoint, I really do love Colleen. If anything, I would rather her be escaping out alive. But in a game point of view, I really thought, because I predicted in my death predictions video that she was going to die and not make it out, I forgot what I was saying. What? I'm gonna look so stupid when I'm editing this. I'm so sorry, future me.
Wookie, wookie, wookie.
But I just really hope she escapes out now, because everybody is actually just proving me wrong from my video, because everybody is just owning up and leading, and especially Colleen. I'm really happy for her, and I actually really hope she escapes the night. TM. This is just kind of like a side note, not an observation. I really did love the scene where Merlin was locked up, even though that's like really bad to say off the bat. I just really love the setting that they had with all the colorful lighting and the dark, mysterious smoke everywhere, and just the situation that they were in. I thought that scene was so, so beautiful, and I'm glad that they did it, because I know Joey must have loved it too. Also, the sorceress again talking to Merlin on the side, that's either setting off an alarm in my head, or she's just really horn. Like, I don't know. You do you, girl. Like, I'm all for you getting you a man's while you trying to escape your death. So the whole scene of when Colleen and Joey went to walk away from the group and discuss what had happened, and Tana just jumping in and getting iffy, I get it. Like, that looks shady as hell, but at the same time, she needed to slow down just like Alex. I was literally all for her stepping up and trying to show her worth, especially after that competition where she had read everything backwards. But I know they were just innocently talking. Like, I know they weren't going to conspire. I mean, I know they did after the fact, but before that, I'm pretty sure they had good intentions, so let's all chill. Something that's not really a conspiracy, it was more of a little bit of attention to detail I saw, was that in the Escape the Night 4 teaser, Joey had the gem, I forget what it's called, I'll insert it here. He had it and he threw it up. I'll also insert the video over here. And as well, this gem made an appearance in this episode, and I feel like it's going to benefit Joey somehow, just because he has it, or it's going to be playing a major role in this season. We need to talk about the situation that happened between Joey and Ro. Literally, what the fuck? Joey was voted in so many times, and a lot of people turned their back against him, and yet he still wasn't voted in. That was nuts. And then Rosanna openly admitting that she voted behind his back against him, that was the biggest shocker ever, because I genuinely thought he was going to protect her and take her along to the end, and now I see confrontation and I don't see that happening. We're all team cinnamon roll on this channel. I get all the comments about her. I love her, nothing against her, but Ro, don't, please don't. I thought it was a pretty cute and cool idea how Alex was trying to shake the table and get everybody up who wasn't in the challenge to go try to save Tana and Gabby. But But at the same time, yet again, his leadership that he's trying to show to everybody was jumping out a little too much, because if anything, he could have got killed. So now we are sadly led to the death of Tana and Gabby. I literally screamed. It's really, really sad if you think about it, because they both thought they were gonna survive, how like they survived together in their season and then they died together. Literally. And that definitely is a setup for something in this season, because like Colleen said, there's only 5 keys left and only 5 players left. So maybe somebody's not gonna die in an episode. Yet again, we have Nikita and Matt coming back, so maybe they're gonna play a part in it. I don't know. Leave down below what you guys think is gonna happen, because I am literally so confused now and I'm so scared for next week's episode. The conspiracy I did want to talk about that I've actually gotten a lot of comments about and I've actually investigated myself is the glass case conspiracy. So every single death that has actually happened in the order that the glass is broken. First it was I Justine, and then it was Timothy De La Ghetto, D-Storm, and now Tana and Gabby. According to it, Alex is going to die next, and I don't think I'm ready. I'm all for people not dying. I don't like that, but at the same time, if he does, I really hope it's not because he was trying to take his leadership too far, you know what I'm saying? But it's just like, at the same time, I really do want to believe it, but I don't feel like they'd be so upfront with it, like just give that big spoiler away. But I don't know, maybe they could. And the final note that I have about Colleen just drinking the tears and then pulling the sword out, what a bad b- and I don't know, I just really love her leadership skills, and I'm so happy because I do love her so much, and I'm really hoping she now escapes the night. But I think that's all I had for the review. This episode was crazy. It was not expected. A lot of tension, a lot of drama, a lot of conspiracies being fed onto, a lot of moments. This week's sunny shout out goes to Thicky Nicky Eglish Muffins. I really love your username, and thank you so much for leaving a comment. It absolutely means the world to me. I will link their YouTube channel down below, and if you guys want to be my next sunny shout out, all you have to do is either leave a comment on this video, retweet my tweet when I tweet out this video's link on my Twitter, or you can share my video link to your Instagram stories, and all 3 ways will automatically enter you in. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video and you want to see more content from me, feel free to hit that like and subscribe button. Also, you can leave me future video recommendations in the comment section below. One last thing, if you like to be notified whenever I upload, please hit that bell button next to the subscription button. That way you'll see my face in your subscription box whenever I upload. All my social medias are linked down below. And yeah, thank you for taking a vacation in my paradise. I hope to see you soon. Bye!